The aviation unit was conceived in 1975 by the chief of the department at that time. Aviation units were becoming recognized as a valuable tool in law enforcement and agencies that had any area to cover recognized that a helicopter could cover that distance a lot faster and more safely than a patrol car. And an officer or two in a helicopter in the air over a busy area can do the work of about five patrol cars. Now, not in the sense of taking reports or actually interacting with people on the ground, but in the aspect of being able to get the calls quickly and advise ground units of what's going on. And as technology increased, you know, also the ability to see in the dark and see what officers were going to before the officers actually got there. Now, most of the requests for our service are either to assist with a person who has fled officers on foot or in a vehicle, where they have a perimeter set up, canine is on the way, and they are requesting our assistance along with canine to maintain and adjust the perimeter as needed, and to work with canine to locate whoever they're looking for. That can occur in any one of a number of types of crimes. Mm-hmm. We also get a lot of missing person calls. Those are common calls. They're made by McDonnell Douglas, and they're called MD-500Es. We have one that's a 1984 model and one that's a 1988 model. Most of the crazy stuff is car chases, because you don't see those. I think the people out in California see those on a regular basis. But here, with our budget, and we're a small unit, with our budgeted allotted flying time and the number of pilots we have, it's actually. And because we're in more of a suburban area rather than down in metro Atlanta, we don't see car chases that much. So when we're actually involved in a car chase or a vehicle chase, those are pretty memorable for us. During the daytime, we patrol at 500 feet above ground level. And at nighttime, during the daytime, that's the best altitude to keep us out of the towers and the wires, but also low enough for us to be able to see what's going on with our own eyes. At nighttime, we climb up to 1,000 feet. Above ground level. That gets us above all the wires and towers, and it's also the best field of view for our infrared camera.